What is up, guys? Been a while since I made a video. Been a while since I've been on the server, actually. So we shall see what all needs to be done. Looks like all the animals are taken care of. We have quite a few sheep, quite a few pigs. We got some corn, some beans. Tab around some of the equipment here. So here's our sheep pile. I believe Jake was loading the truck. I don't think we need to have this here anymore. So we have all of our trees. It's like 520 trees or something like that. It's a ridiculous amount. Yeah, I have my track IR up and running. Oh, there is another pile over here, so maybe we'll hop in that wheel loader. So I believe all the fields are tilled. We don't have a lot of money. I don't believe there's any great demands going on. So I think we're just gonna do some yard work. We have probably 2 or 3 days till our trees are fully grown. These piles are pretty dynamic when you're loading up your bucket. You sure have to go into this pile quite a bit to get a full bucket. Apparently I'm the only one on the server. I don't know if anyone's going to be hopping on and joining us. this kind of looks like some stuff right here. Too bad the dynamic fill planes don't work on multiplayer on the server. You know? So I believe we're done with the loader, so we can drive this back to the farm. So, we lowered the price of wood. The default price of wood is about 10 times what it really should be. If you're looking at the wood being valued at $32 a ton. So it's still pretty elevated, but we dropped the price to a fourth of what it was. Otherwise, I mean, it's kind of, you get rich quick, and it kind of defeats, it's not as fun anymore, for me at least. So we have people parking stuff from random places. So if we look at the map, we are on the second stage of fertilizer. We own 19, 14, 15, 12, 5, and 11. 11 is all grass and trees for our sheep. So what I might end up doing is getting the roller out and just rolling our ground. That way we don't have to use up any fertilizer. We have row crops on our 270. We're pulling a 29 foot 3-inch disc. Wash the sauce since we're done with it for the season. The people asking me what computer specs and what used to record, it's all in the description. Always will be, always has been. So you can read the video description to answer your question. does have a link to my mods on ModHoster. If they're not there, they're not available. Should be pretty self-explanatory. But I think we're gonna take out our large roller here. Work our way up to field 5. That way we don't have to use up any of our fertilizer in our planter. I'm gonna have to obviously get some more seed. I'll probably take the PJ trailer and skid loader down to the dealer and load up on seed. So this tractor's a little small for this 85-foot roller. We don't quite have enough money to pick up these two fields here, make them part of 5. I'm sure we will eventually. This should give us our third state of fertilization. The way the in-game roller is set up is kind of useless, really. Track IR settings are a little messed up right now. nice that they incorporated kind of a mild, diluted down version of soil mod. Gives you a chance to at least use your tillage equipment back in 13 and 15. You can pretty much direct plant everything. And there is no reason to use any of the tillage equipment except besides using your imagination. I think the 10% boost in yield for plowing is pretty low based on how much more work it is than just using a cultivator. Sound file. And when your combiner mowers engage in their harvesting and cutting, would be coming out during the week. I'm assuming you mean the Giants website. I have no idea. I don't really pay much attention to that. I think that's more for console players than PC players. Being on a PC, I don't really have to worry about that stuff. Pretty much do whatever mod want, build and convert. I really don't know how the whole console thing goes. Doesn't really apply to me, so I'm not gonna spend any amount of time to worry about it. There's enough issues with the PC version that need to be addressed that makes sense to pay any attention to consoles. Anyways, this 85-foot roller is making some pretty decent work of this field. I believe we're going to be planting this to soybeans again, just because we get a fairly decent yield and the price is pretty good. I've been following a mod on GitHub for a while. It's called FS Seasons. It's a work in progress, but I believe it's playable now, but it seems like every day they're making and fixing multiple errors. Which is good that they're actively working on that, but still too soon for game. But I like what they're doing. It's seasons affects your yields and your tillage and planting. I suggested that they kind of have seasonal influxes of pricing. You know, like during the winter and stuff, you might have more great demands, less great demands during summer and spring and stuff like that. Maybe even have more vehicle sales spring. I mean, every farm's different when how they set up their fiscal year, but for the average person who's an employee, taxes are right around April, also be decent if you had more brand and equipment sales around that time. Maybe if like seed and fertilizer, if you could prepay, the prices were a little bit lower in the fall. We have less than $5,300 to our name in the bank. I don't know when most people are around to watch live streams. I figured it's 1 o'clock now on a Sunday. I figured it was a good time to do a stream since I was available. that's field 5, El Deno. Hold up our roller here. Nice that they incorporated indoor sound. It always bothered me, especially if you're using headphones, how loud it was to drive and operate equipment from the exterior to interior. On when we're going down the road here. Massive piece of equipment to move down the road. think this might be one of the largest land rollers. 85 foot. I think there might be a manufacturer that makes a size larger than 85. But I think, I know Mandaco, this is the biggest one they make. Summers. I don't think Summers makes anything larger than this. I think Dableman might. Not 100% positive. But it certainly makes quick work of these small fields. Trees, so we'll have to fold up our roller here. Need a small one at the end. Bunch of eggs. Not sure why you can't buy chickens anymore. I'm sure some people enjoy that aspect of it. So Rogue One is out. I haven't seen it yet. I'm sure there's a couple Star Wars fans that are watching. I've heard some non-spoiler reviews of it. I heard the beginning of it really blows, like the title screen, I guess. The one thing you don't mess with is tradition. And I guess they pretty much destroy the traditional Star Wars intro. So we have our meridian up here. Looks like someone might have hit it. We're using this to load our grain from our piles. And I think Jake bought a bucket on the loader to kind of help speed things up. So we use our auger to load up our grain piles. We pile our grain because the silos are full. We're not gonna buy any more storage, but until the price is good. might actually have to sell some grain right now, actually, just to pay our bills. It's nice, the bucket, you can kind of feed the grain, push the pile towards the auger, or you can use the bucket to actually load the truck too. I think it holds like 6,000 liters in the bucket. I heard Road 1 was, aside from the intro, was fairly decent, so I might watch it when I fly back to Wisconsin this week. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoy logging, because based on those trees down there by Field 11, the next upcoming last year is going to be pretty logging intensive. It's nice though, we can probably slow things down a little bit because we bought out the Scorpion outright, so we don't have to waste money renting it. It's a pretty expensive piece of equipment to rent. Every operating hour, it's about 11,000 or 14,000 or something like that, plus the initial upfront cost. I think over the 2 days we were logging, I think it was like 300 and some trees, and we probably spent 70,000 just renting the Scorpion for a couple hours. Took a big hit out of our profits, but I mean, we still made like grand total probably 600 or so thousand gross. Cost nothing to buy the trees. Tree planter was fairly expensive for such a little piece of equipment. We probably spent like 8,000 on renting the tree planters, and then we bought it. Serious Mods sent me a map he was working on. It's a large logging map. Took a peek at it. Seems very promising. Is logging though, so issue is there isn't very many quality logging mods for the game besides the in-game equipment. Everything else out there is unusable. I think that's what prevents a lot of people from getting into logging, is there just isn't a decent amount of usable equipment. I mean, it's kind of weird that they have the whole logging aspect in Farming Simulator, but I guess that's nice to get a little bit of a break, but by doing so, both aspects, both the agriculture and forestry aspects of the game, suffer. You know, neither one is very realistic from a simulator point of view. But I guess from a just playing point of view, it's nice you can take a break from one and do the other. Truck over here. Go dump the rest of this grass in that pile. Might have to take out a loan to buy our seed. A weird place to have a sheep farm, right next to the lake here. Alright, how do we tip this thing? Tip side of back, main door, okay. Now we're gonna want to unload here. It's like running out of space. Thank you. So I have to like empty it into a empty space or something? Tip anywhere is kind of bugged, I think. It won't let me dump in the same spot. Ridiculous. We're gonna head back to the farm, pick up our gooseneck trailer. Trailer. Actually, I'll bring it back. So we don't have a truck yet, so we're pretty much using your semi for everything. heavy haul CT660. I believe this is 535 horsepower. Not the 550. Not like we really need that kind of power right now. Made this skid loader configurable, so it doesn't need any forestry stuff on it. And then we can pick up a few seed boxes here. So these seed boxes hold. Liters. These, the way these skid steers are scripted, same with the Challenger tractors, there's just something about them that isn't quite working. The steering. just don't handle the way you'd expect them to and the way they should. Oh, Giants. Your physics, I'll never understand you. I personally like using the front loader, not the skid loader, to load this stuff. I feel like pallets were so much easier to move around in the 50. Rescript the steering on this thing, because the way Giants has it is completely retarded. sure it's the way the pallet forks are scripted that the collisions are too big. The steering on this thing is so messed up. It's not even funny. Screw it. I'm guessing it's because it's a JCB, it's why it's all messed up. Do something quick. Sell it. Sell that. Get rid of that. Problem solved. Should be enough seed for this season, at least. So I've been streaming for over an hour, so I'm probably gonna call it a day. So thanks for watching.